गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन. टुडे वी हैव डन क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. टेक द पेयर्स ऑफ नंबर दैट हैव मोर देन टू कॉमन फैक्टर्स. ओके, सो हेयर वी हैव टू टेक द नंबर्स दैट हैज मोर देन टू कॉमन फैक्टर्स. सो फर्स्टली वट वी हैव टू डू इज वी हैव टू राइट डाउन द ऑल द फैक्टर्स ऑफ नंबर्स गिवन टू यू, पेयर्स नंबर फैक्टर्स. सो 18 एंड 21. सो हेयर आई हैव रिटन 18 फैक्टर, हेयर आई हैव रिटन 24 फैक्टर. 18 फैक्टर इज 1 मल्टीप्लाई बाई 18 इज इक्वल्स टू 18, 2 multiply by 9 is equals to 18, 3 multiply 6 is equals to 18. So factors of 18 is equals to 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 18. Whereas the factors of 24 is 1 multiply 24 is 24, 2 multiply 12 is equals to 24, 3 multiply 8 is equals to 24, 4 multiply 6 is equals to 24. If you will check in the table of 5, if you will check in the table of 7, if you will check in the table of 9, 10, 24 does not come. Similarly in 11, 13, 14 also 24 does not come. So we have written factors of 24 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24. Now we have to find out the common factors. So 1 is common, 2 is common, 3 is common, then 6 is common. No other factor is common, so we have written all the common factors. As you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we are having 4 common factors, more than 2 common factors, so we are going to put a tick on it. Now 13 and 17. 1 multiply 13 is equals to 13. This is a prime number, so it will only have 2 factors. 1 and the number itself, so 1 and 13. Similarly, 17 is also a prime number, so it will have 2 factors, 1 and 17 here. So factors, common factors of 13 and 17 will be 1. 13 and 17 is not common, 1. So here we are having only one common factor, so we are not going to put tick here. Now let us come to C part, 52 and 65. 52 is equals to 52 factors are 1 multiply 52 is equals to 52, 2 multiply 26 is equals to 52, 4 multiply 13 is equals to 52, 3 table we do not have 52, 5 table we don't have, 6 table, 7, 8, 9 you can check, 52 does not come. Okay, 65 also 1 multiply 65 is equals to 65, 5 multiply 13 is equals to 65, it does not come in the table of 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, okay, 10 also. So factor of 52 we have written 1, 2, 4, 52, 26, 13. Here 64, 1, 5, 13, 64, 5. Now we have to find out the common factors. Common factor is 1, 1 here and 1 more 13 also. 13 is also common, right? So here we have to write 13. 1 and 13 are the common factors, but we have to tick the numbers that has more than 2. It is only 2, so we are not going to put tick on it. So this D part I have given you homework, 72 and 81. You have to find out the factors of 72 and 81. Okay. Now let us come to question number 4. Find the HCF of each set of the numbers. You have to find out the HCF of each set of the number. 1 multiply 24 is equals to 24. 2 multiply 12 is equals to 24. 3 multiply 8 is equals to 24, 4 multiply 6 is equals to 24, it does not come in the table of 5, 7, 8, 5, 7, 9, 10, 11, 13, 15, you can check. Okay, 1 multiply 40 is equals to 40, 2 multiply 20 is equals to 40, 4 multiply 10 is equals to 40, 5 multiply 8 is equals to 40. Okay, so now we have written all the factors 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24, and from here 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 20, 40. Now here what we have to do here is that you have to write the common factors. Common factors you have to write. Common factors 24 and 40. So it is 1, 2, 4, 8 also is the common. Okay, 1, 2, 4, 8 is common. So HCF of 24 and 40 is, we have to write the largest, highest common factor of 24 and 40, so that is 8, so we have written 8 here, this is 8 here, okay. B part I have given you homework, 45 and 30, you have to write the factors by yourself. Now HCF you have to find out. Now we are going to do C part, 12 and 18 and 24, 12, 18 and 24, we have to find out the common, factors of 12 first. Then we have to write down the factors of 18 and 24. So 12 factors are 1 multiply by 12 is equals to 12. Okay. Then 2 multiply 6 is equals to 12. 3 multiply 4 is equals to 12. It does not come in any other table. 18, 1 multiply 18 is equals to 18. 2 multiply 9 is equals to 18. 3 multiply 6 is equals to 18. 24, 1 multiply 24 is equal to 24. 2 multiply 12 is equal to 24. 3 multiply 8 is equals to 24. 4 into 6 is 24. We have written all the factors of 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. 18, 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 18. 24, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24. Now we have to find out the common factors. 1 is common, 2 is common, 3 is common, 4, it has, these two numbers have 4, but it does not have, 18 does not have 4, so we are not taking 4 common. Then 6 is common, as you can see, 6 is common. No other number is common. So 1, 2, 3, 6 is the common factor of 12, 18, 24. It should come in all three numbers. Please remember this thing. So now HCF of 12, 18, 24 is highest common factor here is, highest common factor of 12, 18, 24 is 6. So we have written HCF of 12, 18, 24 is 6. Okay. Now let us come to next question. That is question number 5 that we have to do. Question number 5. Here. So the question here is, three ribbons of length 16 meter, 28 meter, 36 meter need to be cut into pieces of the same length in such a way that nothing is left. What will be the greatest possible length? You have to write down what is the greatest possible length that you have to write. Okay, so here you have been given all three ribbons, lengths of ribbon, length of first ribbon 16 meter, length of second ribbon 28 meter, length of third ribbon 36 meter. Greatest possible length that you can cut into pieces is equals to, what you are going to do is HCF of 16, 28 and 36, you have to find it out. So we have written all the factors of 16, 1, 16, 16, 2, 8 is 16, 4, 4 is 16. 28 is 1, 28, 1 multiply 28 is 28, 2 multiply 14 is 28, 4 multiply 7 is equals to 28. 36, 1 multiply 36 is 36, 2 multiply 18 is equals to 36, 4 multiply 9 is equals to 36, 6, 6 is 36. Now we have written all the factors of all the numbers. We have to find the common factors of 16, 18, 36. So 1, 2, 4 are the common factors. Now which one is the biggest one? 4 is the biggest one. So HCF of 16, 18, 36 is 4. So it means that ribbon should be cut into 4 meter length. If you want to cut the maximum pieces, so it should be cut in 4 meter so that no ribbon is left and it could be cut in equally. Okay. So 4 centimeter is the answer. Now please come on 6th question. Jessica has 27 jasmine and 54 marigold flowers in her flower shop. She gets an order to make an identical bouquet using both the flowers. So she has to make similar type of bouquet using both the flowers. What is the greatest number of identical bouquets she can make that can be made using all the flowers? So she has to make the bouquets, identical bouquets. So they are asking how many bouquets she can make identically. Number of jasmine flower is 27. Number of marigold flower is equals to 54. Greatest number of identical bouquet that can be made using all the flowers is equal to HCF of 27 and 54. 27 is 1 multiply 27 is 27. 3 multiply 9 is equals to 27. 54, 1 multiply 54 is equal to 54. 2 multiply 27 is equal to 54. 3 multiply 18 is equals to 54. 6 multiply 9 is equals to 54. All the factors of 54 we have written. So 27 and 54 factors. Now we have to find out the common factors of 27 and 54. That is 1, 3, 9, 27. Okay, so the HCF of 27 and 54, highest common factor is 27. So we have written HCF is equals to 27. So 27 identical bouquets that can be made with using the all the flowers, that you can be used to making the all the flowers. Okay, please remember. Now look here, we have given you this worksheet homework. This worksheet I am going to give you homework. You have to do some questions in the book. Question number 1 and 2, question number 1, 2 and 5, you have to do it in class in book, and others in notebook. Okay, so that's it for today, everyone. Bye bye, have a good day.